Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you today's video to explore their custom visual, the box and whisker visual. Now, this is going to be great for quickly looking at distributions between several sets of data. And you'll see there's lots of different options, lots of different statistical ways that we can look at these averages. There's various types that we will see, but the best way to look at this, let's check it out in Power BI. Alright, so here within the box and whisker chart by MAQ Software, we can see, as we mentioned, looking and understanding distribution of various different datas. And we can look in our example at sales and profit by city, and then it's broken down by quarter. Alright, and at the top, we have a second axis, and that is going to be our region, which we have a little bit of a hierarchy in play, so it shows that it can work nicely with some of these nice built-in features with Power BI. Now within this, of course, when we hover over, the tooltip is going to be critical when it comes to the box and whisker. It tells us all the information that we want. Standard items that you'd come to expect from box and whisker, of course, is going to be your mean, your median, your max, and your minimum. As well as having those items, as we can see, we get the median of the quartile one range, which that's represented by the bottom line within the box itself. We have our minimum, which is the bottom whisker, because this comprises of two main objects, right? Our box, and then the lines that extend out to the end, which are whiskers, the top one being the maximum, the bottom one being the minimum. The line that we see at the bottom of the box is our Q1, our quartile one value, which is just the median of the first half of the data. And the top line here on the top of the box, that's going to represent the median for the top half of our data. And it's all readily visible in here. We also get the inner quartile range, IQR, which is simply just the difference between Q3, quartile 3, and quartile 1. So all of it readily at our disposal, but we have lots of choices to go even further beyond that. In this case, of course, looking at sales and profit, but we have this nice distribution and breakdown between student grades across different sectors here. So first standard and then section A, B, and C. These are poor performing scores, kind of the distribution amongst that, section B, kind of our middle scores, and then the high scores as well. Now beyond this, we have quite a few options when it comes to what type of actually whiskers we're going to be leveraging here, right? The whiskers representing the min and the max, and that's pretty standard and default, which we see here. To control this, this will actually be in the format area of our visual itself, and we can see we have this section known as box options. And here we're mainly focusing on whisker type. This first one here displayed is going to be using the min and max. So our whiskers, the low end and the high end, are going to match whatever our minimum and maximum values are. Continuing on, we have other options that relate to the inner quartile range. So those whiskers will actually be in play depending on what our inner quartile range values are. This one is 1.5 of the inner quartile range. This one is less than 1.5 of the inner quartile range. Other statistical options are available. As we can see within the dropdown, we have one standard deviation. And we also have this great capability called custom, which then allows us to actually toggle outlier options. As we can see here, I've gone ahead and leveraged the custom option for the box options, and I've said for the lower percentile, it's gonna be 25, and the higher will be 75. Hence, our whiskers now are controlled to that. That's what it's gonna be displayed, and we have those values at the top end. So we have our outliers. Once you have this set to custom, you will notice in the box options near the bottom, you have the capability of toggling on or off our outliers, which is what we see visible here on the second display. So beyond that, we have, of course, additional features for formatting and functionality where we can increase and decrease the size of the boxes and the whiskers. This here, as we can see, can be controlled once again if we go to the format area and the box options. We can see that we have just here the box and whisker width. And in the image here, ascending, we have small, medium, and large just to display how it's done. And lastly, also from a statistical approach, we have the capability of saying if we would like the median, so our Q1 and our Q3 values, quartile 1 and quartile 3s, should they take into account the overall median of the entire set of data here, right? Median being that middle number where mean represents the overall average. So we can have it be inclusive or exclusive of that. Once you kind of get all that set from a statistical perspective, how we would like our box and whiskers to behave and act, just know that we do have capabilities as far as for formatting for the actual symbols for our mean. We have the options between circle, square, and diamond, as you can see, and it is present here. If we hit in the format options, just under the mean area, this is where you can dictate not only the shape, we can also dictate the size and the color of that. And lastly, should we choose, we can have the options of the actual dots themselves. So in this case, these are going to represent these items here, our cities. We can have those items either be turned on or off. And when in the format area, that is just going to be located right underneath where we can see in the dots option just by toggling this on or off. Other elements such as formatting, coloring, sizes of the X and Y axis values, those are as well readily available at your disposal. So lots and tons of options on how we configure MAQ Software's box and whisker chart. Hope you enjoyed and thank you for watching our video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com. Take care.